This is the last guy that works in the office. Sitting right next to me is the newest Techno Buffalo hire. It is Mr. Ron Perita. You might have noticed that back about 3.5 months ago, the video quality on Techno Buffalo started getting way better, mostly because I stopped doing the video editing, and this guy took over. Ron's got a tremendous background in film production. So Ron, why don't you introduce yourself a little bit and give a little bit of your story?
So I've always really had a passion for filmmaking. I kind of started when I was 11 or so. I went to summer camp, actually, and where my mom kind of forced me to go. And I got really into filmmaking and just kind of the process of it, learned Final Cut, started early. Bought a camera that summer, forced my parents to buy me an iMac, Final Cut, and just started kind of editing, making little videos, and for the next 6 to 7 years, I was just always making videos with my friends and that sort of thing. And when I was about, I'm really young, by the way, when I was about 18, I decided to get into commercial filmmaking and started trying to pull clients. That started working. I reached out to John, emailed him one day. I was like, hey, you know, I saw your videos. I think I could really add something. I see, you know, a lot of room for growth.
It's about a year ago. This is when we were still doing Techno Buffalo's Driven.
Right. I actually was more focused in the automotive commercial side of things just because it was easier to market and build a business when you're, you know, really focused like that. So I reached out to John, they were doing a car show, and I was like, you know, let's give it a shot. We actually did the Mazda 2 review.
We did.
Which you can go back and watch.
We'll put a link to that right down below. And it's the best produced video of a car that we didn't necessarily like that much.
I also did have a week to edit that, which I haven't had a week to edit anything ever since I started working here. So
you usually get what, like?
I'd say I get about a day, 2 days, 3 days max. Usually, if I'm really lucky, sometimes, you know, some reviews have gone up within a day. And for me, it's been a real learning experience just because I've been used to having up to a month to edit, you know, a 4 minute video. So when I started here and I was complaining to Ralph and John, I was I can't do this. I get really attached to videos and I'd be no, it's not good enough. It needs to be better. And so getting used to the workflow, the turturnaround time, the schedule, that was all a learning curve. And I'm still learning and I'm still working on it. So it's really a big change for me.
So for the folks out there, you saw that you enjoyed editing or you thought you might enjoy editing. Mm-hmm. So you tried to get the tools that you could to help learn the craft and you just started doing it and sort of the best way to learn. And then you started reaching out to people who you thought might help you get exposure and experience.
Definitely.
And now you sort of did. So we did that video about a year ago. And then probably about 6 months ago, we started looking for a video editor to sort of help with the editing. And my first thought was Ron, who had helped us with the Mazda 2 video. So we talked and Ron's local-ish. Ron's got about an hour or so drive down from Los Angeles. He's in the office usually 3 days a week, Monday through Wednesday, and I handle sort of all the editing. So you edit now, and what kind of software do you use to edit?
I work in Premiere. We use the Creative Cloud here, so it's not just Premiere. We use After Effects, SpeedGrade. Sometimes we use Adobe Audition for some audio stuff, even though we try to get as good of audio quality as we can directly into camera. So that's kind of sweet.
So high level, let's take a general video. Let's say we're doing an unboxing. Mm-hmm. What would you do before we started film, during film, and sort of after filming, for sure, bullet pointed out?
So I'd say before filming, there's not really, that's kind of where your job is. You know, you usually put together a list of points or something like that. For me, it's more trying to find a style and a look for videos. So I'm sure you guys have noticed videos continue changing, and that's kind of why we're still developing a style, we're still working on assets, we're really trying to continue to improve until we're at a point where we're happy. But filming, you know, we'll set up the camera.
The lights around here you guys can't see, but we've got the lights set up all around us.
We've pretty much marked everything down with gaff tape so we know where everything goes, so we try to get as much consistency as we can. We'll just hit record. John's really good usually with one take or so. Unless we have some oddities or something goes wrong with the audio, we usually get it done in one take.
Let me stop from interviewing this Yahoo for a second to thank our good friends at lynda.com. By this point, you probably know them. They offer thousands of super engaging, really easy to follow beauty tutorials brought to you by very pros that know their business that can help you learn software, creative, and business skills. Membership starts at just $25 per month, provides unlimited 24/7 access. You can learn at your own pace from little tiny tutorials or comprehensive courses. If you want to be like this guy and be a pro editor, you can learn web design, programming, video editing, of course, business skills, audio, video, 3D animation, everything in between. Try lynda.com for free for 7 days by visiting lynda.com/technobuffalo. It's a good time to bed yourself. Check them out. Again, lynda.com/technobuffalo. Give you a free trial. So what advice would you give to folks out there who want to get into this field? You know, what have you learned that could sort of help someone that wants to do what you do?
What I would say is be aggressive. You really have to not be annoying, but you really, really have to go out and if you want something, I've always been a big believer in that if you want to do something, you have to go do it. You can't just wish it to happen. I mean, I think if you've asked every single person who's worked here so far, they've said they've made it happen from, you know, Ralph to Brandon. They've gone out of their way, reached out to you, and even you when you began, you did the same thing. So stay hungry. You know, people are going to say no to you for whatever you want to do and just kind of try to take it on the chin, keep going, and just try to go make it happen on your own.
And that's really good advice. If there's a career that you want to go in, whether it's what we're doing or something else, you have to be aggressive with it. And like Ron said, respectfully aggressive. Mm-hmm. I know rejection is going to come. And that's a good point. Everybody here reached out for something that they wanted. And I did the same thing when I was starting. I reached out. Before I started Techno Buffalo, I actually reached out to CNET and Gadget and Gizmodo to try and do video work for them. And nobody got back to me. No one ever replied. So I figured I'm going to try and do it myself. You know, Ron, I'm sure you reach out to a lot of people for video work. I mean, you just created a new video on an Instagram sensation.
Yeah, her name is Grandma Betty. She's I was actually super fortunate about a month ago. She's this 81-year-old woman just fighting cancer, and she's like the happiest person I've ever met. And that was basically it. And she has like over 600 something thousand followers. And I flew out to Indiana for a couple days, got to film her family. That was, you know, I was really fortunate. But that, you know, it's like what you said. I reached out to her grandson on Twitter, and just, you just gotta kind of try to make it happen.
And if you guys wanna see that video, I think it's a tremendous video. We'll link to that down below as well. So at least for right now, this is gonna wrap up the interview series, and other folks that don't work out of the office come in, we'll sort of put them in this chair. Ron's gonna have his hands full over the next few months. We're actually gonna be moving offices around September, October. We're gonna have a full studio inside of our office where we can direct sets and sort of up the production quality. So Ron's gonna have quite a bit of work coming up. We're just gonna name it just the Ron Parita Studio. Ron and Ralph sort of work in really hand in hand. Ralph, who you guys met at the last video, and it's cool to be able to see everybody sort of work together to make this machine run. I know if one person wasn't doing their job, everything would grind to a halt. The fact that we keep growing, the content keeps coming, the videos are there on time, and they're annotated, and the videos look incredible, are all a testament of a lot of people behind the scenes that you don't see. It's not me that does all this stuff. I, in a lot of ways, have the easiest job out of everybody. I just sit here and I talk, and when I'm done talking, I leave, and then the video magically shows up online with the article written about it, with annotations inside of it, with After Effects and color graded. There's a lot of work goes into this, and sort of to the entire staff who's in the office and not in the office, everyone does a really incredible job, and I'm sort of proud and happy you guys got a chance to meet everyone at least a little bit and get to know us and know all the work that goes into everything that we do. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I'll be back next week with a real episode of Ranger's Riffs, riffing on probably something inappropriate. Thank you guys for watching. Of course, check us out and check out Ron's work at technobuffalo.com. Until next week, I'm John Rettinger. See you guys next video. Bye-bye. What's up, everyone? Thank you for watching that video. If you want to see more of the latest and greatest tech news, you can subscribe to our main Techno Buffalo channel by clicking the button right down below in my pants region, or click on the buttons to your right to see more videos.